Thank you, Sham. Good morning. So my name is Dr. Abdallah Sofian Berrouk. I'm from the Petroleum Institute in Abu Dhabi, in UAE. First talk today is about CFD and process simulation of air gasification of plastic waste in a conical spouted bed gasifier. So my talk is organized in this way. So we'll give you a brief background of the work. Then we'll talk about the process process that we are simulating, then the CFD model that we have used for the analysis, and then how we built the equivalent reactor network model for this process, and then we will show you some results with some discussion, and then we conclude. As a background, so the total consumption of plastics worldwide is amounting for £200 billion as of 2013. So plastics have a lower heating value of 40 megajoule for each kilogram, which is much higher if you compare it to the biomass, which is 10, and with the biomass, which is 10, and the coal, which is around 30. So these two, the biomass and the coal, are the most used source of energies. The current plastic waste treatment is based on four technologies. We have landfill, mechanical recycling, chemical recycling, and incineration. So the chemical recycling has the advantage of not only recovering valuable petrochemicals as a feedstock, but also we can recover energy in the form of heat or steam. The advantage, usually, so this type of chemical recycling is made in what we call conical spouted bed gasifier, which has an advantage over the conventional fluidized bed gasifier because of the vigorous solid circulation pattern, high heat transfer rate, and also it's simple to design and it has low segregation of the particles. Okay, based on the hydrodynamics of the gas solid flow in a conical spouted bed, the entire vessel can be divided into four parts. You have the spout, the annulus, the fountain, and the free board. So this is what we have in the literature. The equivalent reactor network, which is called ERN, is a methodology that seems quite suitable for this type of gasifier. So ERN based on a CFD can be developed through a procedure that contains three steps. So the first step is a CFD model that should run and accounts only for the hydrodynamics inside the reactor. And then an image analysis or algorithm is applied for the CFD generated results to create an ensemble of connected zones or compartments. And then each zone or compartment is will be considered as an ideal chemical reactor, and the zero dimensional or first dimensional calculation will be run with the suitable kinetics. So the CFD-based ERN should reasonably simplify the transport process and avoid all this calculation and numerical instability, which is linked usually to a full CFD work. This is usually special for situation when you have many kinds of reactants and complicated and nonlinear reaction paths are involved in the process, which is the case of the plastic gasification. The ERN models usually perform simulation in a very short time, in the order of a couple of minutes on a desktop, while if you do the whole CFD calculation, this will take you a couple of days on workstations or clusters. So a couple of days. So the main objectives of this study that I will show you today is to investigate the use of CFD ERN-based model or CFD-based ERN model to simulate air gasification of plastic waste feedstock that consists of 100% of polyethylene, and this is taking place in a conical spouted bed reactors. So as a process description, so the, you can see it on the right side of the slide. So you have the gasification edge, which is air or steam, is blown upward from the bottom, and we have PE particles, polyethylene particles, coming from the top inlets. So this PE particle, they will melt, and a large amount of volatiles and little amount of tar of char will be released. So this released volatiles are commonly hydrogen, methane, and heavy hydrocarbons, which are usually termed as primary tars. As expected, heterogeneous reaction and homogeneous reaction will take place in the annulus and the spouted zone. And the difference between these two reactions, these two zones, is dictated by the volume fraction of the solid volume fraction, and the contact time with the gasifying agent in both zones. So secondary reaction of TARs usually take place in the free port. This include the secondary reaction, steam reforming, dry reforming, oxidation and cracking reactions. So the products of the secondary reaction are generally non-condensable gases and condensable species, usually termed as TARs and char. The CFD model here, it can show it. So this is the computational domain that that we have used for to represent the conical spouted bed gasifier, and we have used the regular mesh to mesh this geometry just to avoid the convergence and minimize numerical errors. And we have used what we call two fluid models when both the air and the particles are considered as continuum as a continuous phases, and we have used the kinetic theory of granular flow to close all the equations that is linked to the solid phase. So this is all the equation that you have used. We have used the continuity equation for both phases, momentum equation, the turbulence model used, the stress equations. And regarding the closure of the equation linked to the solid phases, we have used the deformation rate, solid phase pressure, solid phase viscosity, granular temperature equation, and the energy dissipation. All of this are derived from the kinetic theory of granular flow. For the drag coefficient, we have used the drag coefficient that depends on the void fractions, where the coefficient of the drag is computed as you can see. This is the CFD results analysis. So these figures, they show the path lines and the flow path lines with solid velocity vectors and the flow path lines with the solid volume fractions. And you can see that the CFD results depicts very well the different zones that we talked about that characterize the solid gas flow usually in a spouted bed. So based on the CFD results analysis, we have divided the gasifier into five zones, or let's say five ideal reactors. So the bottom zones can be modeled using a continuous stirred tank type of reactor, CSTR. The annulus zone also, the spouted zone can be process simulated using plug flow type of reactor, PFR. The fountain zone can be both one of them, you can choose one of them, or the Gibbs reactor, and the free zone is a PFR, as you can see in this diagram. The CFD results also give us the volume, the average volume fraction for each zone or for each reactors, and also the fraction of the mass flux between the connected reactors. And all that is used now to process simulate the gasifier. Now the ERN model that is based on the CFD is developed, and you can see this is the structure of the reactor, the reactor network, and it's based on the five zones that we have developed or we have depicted based on the CFD results. Plus we add on the top of that a PE pyrolysis reactor, polyethylene pyrolysis reactor, and a Gibbs reactor to represent the fountain zone, which is something that wasn't depicted in the CFD work. The reaction involved in this process, on the pyrolysis side, we have the yields of the gas and tar are 64% and 35% respectively. And the gas consists of very small amount of hydrogen, a 0.1 fraction in mass of methane, and 0.79 C2+, so heavy hydrocarbons. The tar is represented by benzene, toluene, and naphthalene. So you can see here the gasification process and all the reaction paths. On the next table, you have all the kinetic parameters that we have used to represent all this reaction taking place in the gasifier. Results and discussion. So for the first thing that you have to do, we have to validate the model. So before we can use it, we can use it further to optimize or to look what are the most important parameters to consider and in which ranges. So we validated the model based on the work of Erika Aga, that is published in Fuel 2013, and you can see that our ARN model prediction of gasification products, including both hydrogen and CU and CH4, are in very good agreement with the experimental data, as you can see here. So here you have the gas composition, and here you have the volume fractions. Okay, now we have, since the model agree very well with the literature, the experimental data that is published in the literature, so we build certain confidence in this model. So now we can use it to study what are the effects of temperature, for example, and the EER, the equivalent ratio, on the performance of the gasifier. So the effect of temperature. So we have lots of results. We have a combination, hundreds of combinations between temperature and EER. But what I will show you here is only the best combination. So for the effect of the temperature, we take a range of 600 to 900 degrees Celsius. And for an EER, I will define EER later, for 0.4, is just 0.4, sorry, there is no degree Celsius here, it's 0.4. And so this results show the effect of the gasification temperature on the product yield. And on the right-hand side, you have the effect of the gasification temperature on the syngas composition, and this at ER equal 0.4. And we can see that at 700 degrees, we have the best performance of the reactor. I will tell you based on what we decide about the performance of the reactor. So usually, we look at these four parameters, LHV, which is the heating value, and we have the CGE, which is the cold gas efficiency, and the CCE, which is the carbon content efficiency, and the ER, which is the equivalent ratio, which is just the weight of the air to the weight of PE in the non-equilibrium divided by the stoichiometric ratio. And you can see that at 700 degrees, we have the highest CGE, the highest CCE, and the highest LHV for the gasifier. Now I will show you the effect of the equivalence ratio. So we took a range of between 0.2 to 0.5 at a temperature of 700, and you can see here both the gas, the composition, and the yield at a temperature of 700 degrees, and the effect of the ER on them. And you can see that at ER equal 0.4, you have the highest, usually the highest gas composition, especially for the synthetic gas. Okay, our conclusion. So plastic waste gasification is one of the most promising technique to use in order to treat solid waste and get the feedstocks and energy. CFD-based Equivalent Reactor Network, CER model, is developed for the simulation of polyethylene gasification in a new designed pilot scale conical spouted bed. CFD-based model is established through two steps. The first step is the CFD to model the hydrodynamics. And the second step is the equivalent reactor network that is built with a gasification reaction embedded into it, and that will what is taken into certain modules that we have developed. The model prediction are in very good agreement with the experimental data of the lab scale conical spouted bed used for the steam gasification of polyethylene. So the developed CFD-based model is used to investigate, after we validated against the experimental work, we used it to investigate the effects of gasification temperature and equivalence ratio on the gasification performance of the gasifier or the CSB. It was found that the proper values of the temperature and the ER for the air gasification of polyethylene are 700 degrees Celsius and 0.4. With this operation condition, so we will get syngas with an LHV of 6.2 megajoule, and a value of CG of around 72%, and a value of CCE of around 97%. So the present work demonstrates the capabilities of this developed CFD-based ERN model to simulate polyethylene gasification. The work also demonstrates the appropriateness of the designed pilot scale conical spouted bed gasifier to carry out such important process. Thank you very much.
Do we have any questions? Questions, one here.
Well, if I understand well, your CFD model is without reaction. Yes, and it is not possible that if it is a large amount of volatiles released, the dynamics of bed is changed completely during reaction.
I agree with you. It just this is the approach. So the approach is to look how the fluidization is inside the air gasification, and I agree with you that if you put the reactions, so this can affect to a certain extent the hydrodynamics. But I think it's the thermal effects that affect more the hydrodynamics. But yeah, I agree with you.
Yes, yeah. Any more questions? One here.
Thanks for the talk. You said the simulation results fitting well with the lab scale experiments, right?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm wondering which kind of the reactors you use in the experiments, and do you need a catalysis for this pyrolysis process?
No, the experimental work wasn't done by us, so it was found in the literature. So I don't know if they have used certain type of catalyst for the gasification, but my guess, I don't think so that they did use that. But I don't know, to be honest, yeah.
I have a question. Did you investigate the effect of particle size of the PE whenever they change, how they will affect the CFD simulation and therefore the reaction network in HYSIS or Aspen Plus?
Yeah, this is a good point. We have used the distribution that is given in the experimental work, and we gain confidence in our model so we can investigate that in the future. Yeah, but it's a very good point, yeah.
Any more questions? Any questions over here? No? Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.